60 Minutes Overtime.
We went to China to look at the electric car industry because it seems that China is really poised to dominate this industry. Chinese cars are sort of known for being not necessarily very good quality, pretty inexpensive. What NIO is trying to do is build an all-electric car that's also a luxury car and that is appealing to newly wealthy Chinese who have money to burn and want to spend $60,000 on a car. That's roughly what a NIO costs. One of the founders, William Lee, told us, we're not really a car company, we're a lifestyle company. And that's kind of a cliche. A lot of companies that actually sell things, that sell stuff, want to tell you that they're a lifestyle company. But I think with NIO, there's an element of truth to it. William Lee clearly feels that he has a very clear understanding of newly wealthy middle class or upper middle class Chinese. This new class of prosperous Chinese people who have had money for a while now, have been able to buy the things that they want for a while now, and are starting to think about what they want their lives to be like, what they want for their children. And he clearly thinks that NIO, his car, can be part of that.
If you're buying a car, you're not just buying a vehicle, you're buying a ticket to a new lifestyle.
And so he's doing several things. First of all, if you buy a NIO car, you get an app, and that connects you with an entire kind of social network of other NIO owners. And then NIO has also set up these places called NIO houses.
There are some things beyond the car. The second floor is like a clubhouse.
Oh, you can't come here unless you own a NIO or you've ordered a NIO.
Yes.
And then you're part of the club.
Yes.
And you get to hang out here.
Yes.
And they're in some of the kind of most expensive real estate in places like Beijing and Shanghai. And the idea is that if you're a NIO buyer, you can go to these places and they offer things like flower arranging courses, teaching you about espresso coffee, how to make an espresso coffee. There's the playroom for kids. It's a place to socialize. And the idea is that NIO helps offer them a kind of upper middle class lifestyle. I think that it's fair to say we were a little bit skeptical about how appealing NIO houses really were to Chinese consumers, but we met some of them, and I think that kind of changed our minds. In particular, a man called Ben Cui. And he was there picking up his brand new NIO, so he just spent $60,000. And he, after much research, I think as he'd been researching this for a year, had decided that the NIO was the way forward for him. So instead of buying an American car or a German car or a Japanese car, he had decided he was going to go with a NIO. And part of the reason for that was that he liked this kind of entire social life that went with the car. You're going to make friends through this car. And he was there with his parents, who I guess must have been probably maybe in their late 60s or 70s. So they had lived through a very different period in Chinese history. It's so interesting to think that what they have lived through. And then their son is now buying a $60,000 car. It's pretty amazing.